Hello, everyone. Thanks so much for joining me today. My name is Lydia, and this is Time with Lydia, the Pharmacist. A big thank you to all who have subscribed to this channel. Your support is much appreciated. This is a channel where we educate ourselves on common health problems. So if you're new to this channel and you want to learn more about your health, then please hit on that subscribe button and also on the notification bell so you don't miss anything that I upload. Today, I'm going to be spending some time with you talking about a very common skin condition called eczema. There are various forms of eczema, but our main focus today is going to be on the most common form called atopic eczema. It normally starts in childhood, with 90% of the cases occurring in children under 5 years of age. Atopic eczema can also develop in adults. Atopic eczema can have a genetic link, and research shows that children born to one or two parents with atopic eczema or have siblings with atopic eczema are more likely to suffer from it. Also, a third of children with atopic eczema will develop asthma and/or hay fever. People with eczema tend to have an overreactive immune system that, when triggered by a substance outside or inside the body, responds by producing inflammation. It is this inflammation that causes the red, itchy, and painful symptoms of eczema. Also, they have very dry skin because they are unable to retain moisture, and this lowers their resistance to irritants. Eczema is a skin condition that is not contagious, but can cause a lot of physical and emotional distress. It can be frustrating, annoying, and painful, and can have a negative impact on the quality of life of the sufferer. It can affect any part of the body, but commonly presents on the hands, inside the elbows, back of the knees, the face, and scalp in children. Severity of symptoms vary from person to person. There are periods when symptoms can become mild and less worrying, and times when symptoms become severe and flare up. Mild symptoms present with patches of dry skin, occasional itching, and some redness. Moderate symptoms include patches of red skin and frequent itching, which can make the skin thicken. And severe symptoms will present with large red areas, dry skin that is always itchy and cracked. The skin may bleed or ooze. The exact cause of eczema is not known, but it is likely related to a number of factors, which include allergens, example, pollen, dust mites, moulds, animals, hair dyes, perfumes, and cosmetics. Fabrics, example, wool, silk, and synthetic fabrics can irritate the skin. Cleansers, example, shampoo, laundry detergents, bubble baths, hand soap, surface cleaners can cause a flare-up. Certain foods such as cow milk, egg, peanut, soy, and wheat are triggers. Stress is also a trigger for 9 in 10 people with eczema. And this is because stress can weaken the immune system and cause an inflammatory reaction in the skin. The weather and temperature are triggers. Most people tend to feel better during the summer months than in the winter. Heating during winter dries up the skin. Hormonal changes can also trigger eczema. Women may find out that their symptoms get worse before their period or during pregnancy. I'm going to talk you through some self-care tips that can help reduce the symptoms and prevent flare-ups. 1, reduce scratching. Scratching can make the symptoms worse and cause the skin to thicken. Instead, you can try to gently rub your skin with your fingers. Keep your nails short, because deep scratching can cause the skin to break and put you at risk of getting a skin infection. Secondly, identify the triggers and avoid them. Example, if there is a kind of food that you identify as a trigger, then find a substitute that will provide you with the same nutrients. You can speak to your pharmacist or your doctor to help you with this. Also, avoid fabrics that irritate your skin. Clothing made of cotton are the best, as cotton is breathable and make the skin feel comfortable. Wear gloves when you're handling cleansers and foods that trigger eczema. Avoid using soap and detergents that irritate the skin. And thirdly, manage stress. And you can check out the link to my video on useful tips for managing stress in the description box below. Apart from the self-care tips, you can also buy some preparations from your local pharmacy to help manage eczema. These are preparations that can be prescribed by your doctor as well. Emollients are very good in the management of eczema. They moisturize the skin and prevent it from drying up. They come as creams, lotions, and ointments. And examples include dermal lotion, dermal cream, and zero base. The difference between the various forms is the oil content. The ointment contains more oil and it is for very dry skin. The lotion has the lowest amount of oil and it is for less dry skin. The cream falls between the two. The ointments are more greasy, but they tend to help retain moisture on the skin, so preferred when the skin is very dry. Emollients do not contain any perfume or any anti-aging additives. It's good to note here that one emollient that is good for one person may not be good for another. And it is also advisable to use the emollient you like, because if that is the case, then you are more likely to use them more often. It is advisable to use an emollient the right way in order to get the maximum benefit. So now let's talk about some good ways of using an emollient. Use it regularly, at least twice a day and every few hours when there is a flare-up. The recommendation is 500 gram for an adult and 250 gram for a child per week. Wash with an emollient soap substitute instead of soaps and shower gels. Anytime you wash or shower, pat your skin dry with a soft towel and apply emollient immediately. Apply it in the direction of hair growth and do not rub up and down, as this can trigger itching. Apply a more liberal quantity, that is a thicker than normal quantity, before swimming to protect the skin from drying up. And when you have to use a steroid in addition to an emollient, there is no standard rule as to which one should be applied first. The only thing you need to do is leave 20 to 30 minutes in between the two applications to avoid diluting the strength of the steroid. Always apply the emollient all over the skin, not just on the areas with eczema. And continue to use the emollient even when the eczema has improved in order to prevent flare-ups. It's important to note that aqueous cream is no longer recommended for eczema, either as an emollient or a soap substitute. And this is because it contains sodium lauryl sulfate, which can irritate the skin and make eczema worse. Also note that emollients contain liquid paraffin, which can build up in clothing, beddings, towels, and bandages. This can catch fire if it comes into contact with naked flame, such as cigarettes, lighters, candles, or heaters. The fire that results burns more easily and faster. So as much as possible, make sure you don't get close to a naked flame and wash your beddings and towels regularly. Note also that bath emollients can create a slippery surface, so make sure it is washed off thoroughly after use to avoid falls. A bath mat or handrails may be useful. Now let's move on to topical steroids. These are creams and ointments, and they help reduce redness and swelling during flare-ups. The potency of topical steroids vary. We have the mild, moderate, strong, and very strong. And the strength prescribed by your doctor is based on the severity of the atopic eczema and the area affected. Antihistamines also help with severe itching. There are two groups, the sedating and the non-sedating. The non-sedating is the preferred choice. But when your sleep is disrupted because of the itch, then your doctor or pharmacist would prescribe a sedating one to help you sleep at night. They can cause drowsiness even into the following day. Examples of the non-sedating antihistamines are loratadine, cetirizine, and acrivastin. And an example of a sedating antihistamine is clofenamine. You can buy all these from your local pharmacy. Medicated bandages and body suits can be prescribed by your doctor in some cases. The medicated bandage can be used over emollient or a steroid to prevent scratching and allow the skin to heal underneath, and also to prevent the skin from drying out. Some people find herbal remedies useful. It is always advisable to speak to your doctor or your pharmacist before you use any herbal preparation, just to make sure it is safe for you. I hope you have learned something new today. If you have, then please give this video a thumbs up. Also, remember to share the video with family and friends. Leave your comments and your suggestions in the comment section. If you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, then hit on that subscribe button and also on the notification bell so you don't miss anything that I upload. It's been a pleasure having a chat with you. Thank you once again for joining me today, and I hope to see you soon in my next video. Bye for now.